That's a great question. Well, first off, I'm just happy to have a full roster back. To have Josiah James back and, you know, Braylyn, who sat out again. So now, yeah, just really in a situation where we're really trying to just kind of solidify who we are. Really proud of, like, how well we've played and the things we've done. We've grown so much, you know, but really just right now, really want to get to a point as we're going into game eight. Really trying to figure out, and I think the greatest thing about this team is going to be different people to step up at different times. But you're always going to have, you know, your Julians and your Myers, the different people. So what I have learned is that we're a versatile group, and we're just continuing to grow. I'm just really proud of her and her growth and, you know, again, during the offseason. She spent a lot of her offseason, like, really getting in shape and really working to be in the best shape possible. And so now, understanding and learning the game as far as how the refs are calling. I think a lot of early games, she got into some quick and early foul trouble. And I think now she's really starting to understand and grasp during the game how the refs are calling. But, you know, Carissa is very talented. Has great hands, can score around the basket. And so I was really proud of her and how she stepped up and just really proud of her growth. And we need that. We need to become an inside out team. And that's what, you know, we have been working toward. And so really just proud of her. Well, her energy is unmatched. When she comes in, and she just brings a ton of energy for us. And really, in our game against Charlotte, she was the one that sparked us. You know, we got off to a slow start. So her ability to, like, change people's shots, you know, she's athletic, she can jump, you know, understanding how to jump up straight in the air. And, you know, she had, like, 8 rebounds. And, you know, she's just growing. And it was really great to see her and Clarissa both really step up for us and come off the bench, because that's something that we really needed, especially when you're in a tournament and you're playing back to back.
You said that you wanted to see Jillian stay aggressive. Wins and losses aside, have you liked what you've seen from her aggressiveness? And not just on the court, but as a leader in that
room? Oh, definitely. She is. I think she's continuing to grow each and every day. Her aggressiveness, I think, speaks from volumes from how people guard her in different ways and the things that she does and how she can go from, you know, playing with her back to the basket, also facing up, you know, against Charlotte. She brought the ball up before a lot, right? So she has been it's been awesome to watch her grow. But, you know, I'm always constantly on there too and challenging her, not just myself, but the coaching staff. So I'm really proud of her and I'm proud of her growth. And I think that the team also continues to see her grow on a daily basis. And, you know, that's why our team is I know I'm right, you know, we're 4-3 right now. We easily should just only have one loss. You know, we've lost 2 games by total three points. So this is something that we're really trying to make sure we hone in on and make sure that we get them very comfortable in whatever situation that is. So, yeah, it's really been perfect. That's a great point, and it really is very important for us. And it's something actually, you know, we watched them earlier today, you know, before scout, and we're just really talking to them about the spacing on the floor and our transition game. That's something that we really challenging our team. We have a quick, big, athletic team, and we got to make sure we can learn how to get up and down the floor and be able to score more in transition. So that's something that we've been trying to focus on.
You guys scored 44 points in a few times this season, the most since last year against North Carolina A&T, 52. That's something you're looking more established at the team here, and even heading into the middle portion of the season, when you get more paint touches for this team.
Definitely, because, you know, as we said, you know, as I said a few minutes ago, you know, being able to play inside out and stretch the floor. A lot of it also comes too with, you know, getting rim runs and transition baskets and things like that. So just something that we really just, what we're really trying to do is make sure we can simplify things for this group, but be really good at things that we do. And so I feel like that's something that has been really good for us, and it's just something that we want to focus on. So definitely an inside game is something that we really want to make sure that we're focusing on.
How encouraging is it that my jobs have been to, you know, scoring assists, field goal percentage, despite that kind of pretty much bounced off the ball this
year? Yes, that's a great point. You know, I think it just shows the all-around player that she is, and I think it also says a lot about, you know, she's at Seton Hall, and she spoke about this, but she's played off the ball a lot also, too. She's a great three-point shooter, and that's something that we're going to really try to make sure that we continue to make sure we emphasize with her and, you know, get her off the ball sometimes at the point so she can play that off-position, too, and just be able, so she can, you know, be able to get back to, you know, shoot the three as well as she has. Yeah, I think I'm super excited for her. And, you know, she got back, really worked hard, coming back off the ACL injury. And then, you know, she got a fracture, you know, that it was out with her hand. So, you know, adversity has hit her really tough, but she's a tough young lady. She really trusts us and the staff and, you know, everyone around, the trainers and everyone else. And so it's been a great transition in allowing her to be able to, you know, kind of get her feet wet in the tournament. And that's what it was. Let's get out here. Let's, you know that with your hand, you're probably going to miss a couple passes. You're going to do some things, but let's just get you back out there in the middle of everything. And was really proud of how she responded.
You guys are like, how's that going to be able to help you later on in the next week? Like, mentality, having in the middle portion of the season, going to be able to help this team, you think?
Oh, it's going to be really important for us, and we're really glad that we can have the opportunity to have some depth and be able to really have points off the bench. It's really important. I think we all know and understand the game that if you can have multiple people that can score in different ways, I feel like that's always something that can give you an advantage. And I think that's something that we're really trying to work toward, is trying to make sure that we can be the best version of ourselves, meaning having different people step up at different times.
Hey, Brandon, just talk about this offseason for you. Obviously, you're coming off the season, you're going to be very successful to my season. Just talk about this offseason, what things are you going to be working on in your sophomore season?
Is there any kind of contributing factor to this three-point struggle so far this year? Obviously, a lot of success everywhere else on the floor, leading the team scoring assists, overall field goal percentage, but the impact of three-point not quite yet fine.
Yeah, I think for me, it's just continuing to shoot, continuing to be confident. I have struggled a little bit, but nothing that I'm too worried about. My team is going to keep fighting, keep trying to shoot the ball, and just when I get the ball, don't hesitate, keep shooting.
What are you guys overall, just kind of for both of you, actually, really well impressed with the data and how the event went, I guess, close to
you? Yes, a lot of people, I think, that the very first game, we were very, very proud of ourselves, very, very proud of our energy, and just keep pushing on, getting that big one for us. They were a great team. This guy prepared just to be able to, you know, go out there was phenomenal. And then Charlotte, you know, they're also a really good team. It's a little much more one point, and it just takes, like, little things that we have to clean up, which we're going to be able to practice, so,
being in the team, so I just think that I just blessed to come back.
to be a
precious message. She wants to really start to accept the Lord and thank the Lord and say, and obviously, you do. Of course, I can't do this in my space of words. Talk about what that means to you. I've said for this. Grace is coming up for prayer. And we've just been able to see from her.